Okay, thank you. So my name is Valery, and I will talk then in English. That's better, I guess. So what I will be talking about is basically how we evolved quality in Avira in the last couple of years, and basically what we learned from this. So who knows what Avira is, so what they do? Okay, Avira is basically mainly known for antivirus solution. So it's actually pretty known in Germany and well in that region. But it's not only antivirus. So we also have device protection, device performance solutions, speed up for Windows and for Android app. We have extension around browser safety. We even have our own browser, Chromium based. We have a couple of mobile applications. And now we have the VPN solution. And we have a couple of other things which we are building in. So it's several things. And what I'm doing, I'm head of QA at Avira. And I will explain in a minute what this means. Okay? And I'm here in Deutschland since my letzte Jahr. In zwischen habe ich irgendwie Deutsch gelernt, natürlich, aber ich mache Fehler noch, deswegen war es eine Frage, ob ich diese Präsentation auf Deutsch oder auf Englisch liefern sollen. Und ja, aber wenn jemand hier nicht Deutsch spricht, dann werde ich auf Englisch alle liefern. Ja, Ausnahme. Okay? Yeah, and before that I come from Russia. I worked a lot with American companies, but I'm not coming from Kaspersky, never worked with antivirus before. This is what I'm doing. So basically, how our engineering setup looks like. So we have several tens of agile teams, and they are basically, we are trying to do that they are running on their own. And we have a distributed testing organization, and I will spend a minute what this means. We have basically different technology stacks. We have web, we have mobile, we have Hadoop, we have cloud and stuff like this. And we have two engineering gel locations. Germany, we are situated near Bodensee Lake in the South Germany. Nice location, by the way. And the other location is in Bucharest. Okay, historical reasons. So what is the problem statement? So basically we wanted teams to deliver frequently, ship frequently, and we reorganized ourselves accordingly towards many small engineering teams. And what happened is basically they start to release something and well, didn't work. Well, didn't connect to this and stuff like this. And people were kind of angry, and basically we needed to do something. And what I learned about Germany, people love Ordnung here, okay? Very much love, so pretty much we went to the situation where we did not have any Ordnung. And okay, and by the way, from quality perspective, the idea was that we have some problems in testing. So what do we do? So the company brought me in, and we needed to actually do something. So what did we do? So first we actually had to make the conscious decision how our testing will be organized. And we said that we actually want the testing organization to be fully distributed, which means that we will not have a separate testing department. So this is where we started from. So we had this big separate testing department. Then we moved the manual testing inside the teams. Separately, we had this automation testing. Obviously, that didn't scale, it didn't work. Then we distributed that across. Now we have everything distributed except for it's a small team focused on the integration. But what's important is that we want teams to be responsible for quality. So this is the key for us. As such, we have this separate small team focused on the integration, but we want this to be more like a service team. So this is our idea, okay? And we want to run some kind of community. We have HipChat run around quality. We have seminars and stuff like this. And what I find interesting, when I wanted to do some picture here, I wanted, okay, distributed organization. And this is a picture which comes in from Google. What I find interesting is that it's actually this picture, centralized, decentralized, and distributed. What we actually have is actually this decentralized thing, and I find it's funny that, okay, with community, it's this shift. Does it make sense? So it's more like what distributed versus decentralized mean. Like I didn't myself reflect upon this, But this is kind of exactly what in my community is. So the people a little bit learn from each other, and we're not there yet. So we are actually really decentralized community thing proves to be a challenge for us at the moment. Now, we also align how we actually go around pet production. So we call it a GitHub concept, and the way to go around this, we said that okay, each team does this GitHub street, and development would be everything the developer does. Testing would be the CI system, and then we have acceptance, like one for everybody, integration environment, and then we go to production. And we really want each team to actually ship what they want, which means that obviously this thing needs to scale. So, and this thing can easily become the bottleneck, and all the effort is around that it doesn't become one. Okay? So, this is what we said, that we want each and every team to follow this approach. And we had actually did not have this, so we took some time to actually build some of the things which we didn't have, even have the full actually staging environment. And then some of the teams actually used only staging environment, and the work is okay. And they needed to be put more into the testing level, so they really test on itself and don't break the acceptance too much and too often. And the idea is really that to put effort here so that acceptance doesn't become a bottleneck. And for us, it really was a challenge and still is a challenge. So to have this soup when everybody does their own thing, but then has this integration test and runs to production.
Can you make a question?
Sorry?
Okay. Can you make it up? I didn't get this distributed concept. Is it until test or really?
It's from an organizational standpoint. So we have these testers, QA people who are doing all the testing, they're inside these engineering teams.
Yeah, but when you show this DTAP, is it that's until production? Until production is all distributed, or distributed is development and test, and the acceptance integration means it's central?
Yeah, so pretty much we want testing to be like their team, so that they're doing what they want in their own thing. It's not expectation is that it's not stable, and you have the emulators there, it's something cannot work. But in acceptance, it's basically a copy from production. And with that, basically comes the idea how you do this integration testing thing. So we have now a separate team focused on this integration tests, and they're fully automatized and run continuously. And this is actually where we started from. We actually arrived at the situation where we were investing too chaotic, and we didn't even understand what is overall the quality idea of the quality. So this test for us served actually as a business monitoring thing. So we really actually knew when stuff broke and stuff like this. So these are end-to-end actually UI tests, and this is what we have now. And then we use them on acceptance, and it's used as a service for the team so that they run their application specific tests, and then when they before they go to production, they run on this acceptance environment, this end-to-end regression suite. So this is more like integration testing approach. Yes,
if everything is automated and running continuously, why do other teams not able to use this?
Maybe that would be the next thing. So basically we are, this is what we did, and it's kind of like a journey. So this is what for us, where we start, longer term, maybe that's exactly what will happen. So that team will need to basically write the test. So this separate integration team might disappear in the years to come, so we will see.
But you are quite far. A lot of companies don't have that much.
Thank you.
That's good.
Yeah, but we don't have much, frankly speaking, so I will talk about this. So basically, we need to start somewhere. And this is where we started. We wanted some end-to-end tests running on a production, then on acceptance. So production they're using as a business monitoring, and we see actually the statistics. And on acceptance right now, it's really to have this additional layer of testing on top of the application-specific tests, which will then be served as a service. But frankly speaking, we don't have actually here much in some teams. So which, but actually for them, they are kind of saved by this sometimes. So if they do something and they don't run any tests or like not many tests, this integration tests actually kind of gives them a little bit of confidence before they run to production. And if they still break something, then this test will indicate on production that something is wrong. And in order to be able to do this, this thing needs to be really small and lightweight. And yeah, as you said, so pretty much in the long run, it may be dissipated in the tips. So let's see. And it's really critical, but it's really critical to kind of automatize. It's the only way that actually teams will use it as a service. Because if it runs always and very quickly, then it can be used by the teams. If it's really something which you need to kind of schedule to ask for it, then you really don't scare. Okay. And the other thing which I did was this overall quality strategy. So overall, across the teams, what it means to be the what is quality strategy? What I did is like a light build. So what I said is okay, a custom thing. So over quality, this is each and every team needs to do, and to have a story around this, I call key quality bureaus, in order to have a good story around testing. And if you are doing this, then you should be in decently good shape. And each team then have their own approach, obviously, but it needs to be kind of in line with this. A quality light build. And when you have this, I have each team to do this exercise, and then out of this, where are we strong in our approach, and where are the not so strong maybe things. And this is how it looks like. So this development and testing, which I talked about, is one thing. Then we have quality metrics. Very important for us is this overall idea of the dog fooding thing. Then the softer idea of the overall quality mindset, quality build is the community thing, and you need to have a strong story about how you approach the CI and continuous delivery and stuff like this. So each team does this consideration and they see what could be the potential next steps to become better at engineering. This is where I said that, okay, this is our like, things that will help us move forward for many teams.
Somehow. What's dog fooding?
Dog fooding means that you use your own products, you do internal rollout before you release to production, and you try to use the beta community, so different flavors, but it's really variable because you do, for example, rollout not like everything at once, and maybe for 5% and see how that works. So there are really different flavors of how it can be done and is done, depending on the technology. But I really strongly feel that this is one of the key quality pillars because it really complements for whatever you are not testing. And really, whenever you are actually using your product, or your parents or your family use your products, it really you find something. So all your testing, automated, manual, exploratory, whatever you do in the company cannot complement by this. So actually, I strongly feel that it's meaningful to have a strong story, and actually meet up Zicht, do this, okay? And by the way, so for us, for example, when we had the all-hands meeting and we said, okay, how many of us are actually using our own Avira products, anything like this? And it was like 40%. Okay, it's not where we are, where we want to be, okay?
It means you tell the guideline what you want, and then how do you do that? It's doubtfully.
Yes, absolutely, because but this is on one hand, it's a place to start. On the other, really, the story is really different for each other team, different technologies. So it's really different, for example, how you do it for mobile, how you do it for the website, how you do it for the licensing backend system. So some of the things are not applicable or run differently. So it's really the story about the testing automation. You cannot say, okay, everybody tomorrow it's like 80% code coverage. So it's really actually difficult to when you have different teams and different technologies to actually have the, like a standard. But the place to start exactly this for me at least, and for us, okay, we need to have a story for each of these things. and to see if this story is strong enough, and if no, what is it that we want to do in the upcoming months to actually make it something which we are really happy with. And then, so it's kind of like ramen, and this, basically the story is really for each product, for each team. Yeah. And what we did also in terms of agile planning, so our job planning is we have roadmaps. On the roadmap we have epics and we have user stories. So what we said about the whole integration testing idea, that we will hook it up into the epic definition process. So now it's we have vision, we have roadmap, we have planning, we have iterations, we have data. So we hook this integration testing into one page of template for the epic. So we really said that, okay, we want to integrate it on the epic basis, and for the user stories and whatever, it's what they do, anything. And we made it part of the definition of ready guideline on epic level. So we have this definition of ready, definition of done, and we said that, okay, the important thing for us is the definition of ready for the epic thing. This is where we want to align, kind of at the beginning. Then what the team do with the like application specific part is basically up to them, but they are really, we're really better off actually that everything then goes not like this, but more like this, if we align the beginning. And we call it between several teams. And we call it definition of ready guideline, and basically defining and aligning on the epic up front. And this story about integration, and if we need this separate integration team involved, then it's part of the thing, like upfront a little bit. I can send, by the way, slides if you want, so no problem with that as well.
Just want to read.
Yeah, more than welcome. Yeah, so it's actually, as I said, it's actually meaningful to conceive this experience in advance relatively. And we don't want to go too far with this, otherwise it will be a lot of integration or this like big projects. This is not what we want to run. And we all actually consider that this whole integration story, we need it only in small percentage of everything that we do, like 10-20% of epics. It's going back to your question around if the teams would be doing this, do we need the separate integration teams? But for now it makes sense because it's only like 10% of all the epics which we do. And, but there it makes sense because it comes across several teams. Yeah, and yeah, it's actually for us a work in progress. Yeah, and our agile story, so I'm really talking more about this quality thing, how we deliver, how we're doing it for, because this is what I am doing. So our agile story, we actually have, so Nikita is our agile coach, so I saw somebody, actually, name is known. And she is coaching us for this agile, and she's coaching us for the mindset. And yeah, we have really this balance between alignment and flexibility, which means that we are aligning on the roadmaps on Epic and what this means. Then the user stories, how people are basically using Scrum, how they are estimating, not estimating, it's up to the team. So this is where our alignment lies. And we have kind of like agile community, bi-weekly seminars, and yeah, our agile coach then worked with some teams to make it work. And what are the lessons learned? So the lessons learned are that basically the signature is that we want teams to enable to ship frequently. So this is like the criteria. Whatever we do, this is the where we need to arrive at. So we need to kind of keep this work. So for us, the story is really, it's not like scaling in terms of we grew much. It's really we went too far in basically the become too chaotic. So we need to do something. But we needed to actually make sure that we are still actually enabled teams to do frequently. So from test engineering, that means that actually all the testing or most of the testing needs to be application specific. And there is no silver bullet, but it's the idea is to actually have it minimized somehow, this integration testing part. And the integration parts need to be lightweight and fully automatized. So this is like not negotiable, because otherwise it will become bottleneck from day one. So organization, we actually very strongly, our lesson learned is we really should be focused around products more than around systems. It actually goes back into what was said in the keynotes. This way people have vision, this way they are really aligned, and whatever needs to happen, they just do it. For example, the, relatively recently we made this VPN product, and yeah, we do it exactly like this, and it worked better. And the separate testing organization is really the slow and dark factor. We don't want to go back to this. And yeah, but if we go too distributed, that's exactly where it becomes chaotic. And we have quality things. And what we did, actually, we exactly did these things which I talked about in the slides. Okay? And it's really all about the balance between alignment and flexibility. So for us, we went into this like more flexible part and became chaotic. If you align too much, going back to what we discussed yesterday, one process for many teams, then you lose this flexibility. So where to draw the line? My answer is you need to be as flexible as you could, but you need to be mindful, because if you're too flexible, you start, it becomes expensive because people do not learn from each other, or you're really not leveraging from this harmonized, you have too many tool stacks and stuff like this. And for us, we have the quality of problems. And for me, the lesson learned so far is communities are really hard to manage, to cook. It's not that you manage something. But if you do, then it's cool. It's really something which actually inspires me. And for us, it's actually like a journey. So actually the company is 30 years old. And for us, the journey of Agile is several years old. The journey which I talked about, so I'm with the company, is like Let's Demai. And in Zwischen haben wir was gemacht, aber wir haben gesagt, dass viele Dinge work in progress sind. Und ja, wir machen das Schritte noch sozusagen. Und one thing is the OK community. Then we have a lot of technology that's located in everybody else, including in architecture, including in testing, including everywhere. And we really feel that we will further organize around products. And for us, this engineering productivity is a topic, harmonizing for tooling, for example. And this is also something which I guess we need to tackle. We have several different tooling stacks, including like more than one version of Git, for example. We have some legacy systems. So this engineering productivity topic will be something which we will tackle. So das war alles. So, danke euch, und ich bin hier den ganzen Tag, so ich würde gerne, sehr gerne dann elaborieren und erklären auf anything.
Thank you.
Thank you.